Hey, y'all. Welcome to part 7 of the Vectric version 12 plus for absolute beginners video series. In this video, we're going to revisit the basic clock face that we made back in part 3 of this series, and I'm going to make a few modifications using a couple of different tools. I'm also going to describe a pretty neat feature that's built into the Vectric software. Now, although I'm demonstrating this in VCarve Pro version 12.009, this works exactly the same way in VCarve Desktop, VCarve Pro, and Aspire. To begin with, if you remember back in part 3 of this series, this is just a basic clock face that I was going to cut out of maple plywood. Then these circles here represent holes I'm going to drill and then fill with walnut dowel. Then these here were some quarter inch holes that I were going to drill and fill with oak dowel. And then this circle is the hole for the shaft on the clock movement. Well, not long after I made this face, I decided that I was kind of limiting myself, and maybe I could do some design changes. What I've decided I want to do is I want to offset these 3/8 diameter circles and create 4 3/4 inch diameter circles. Then cut those holes and fill them with walnut dowel. Then drill these 3/8 inch circles into that walnut dowel and fill these with oak dowel to match these. That will give us a nice dark walnut stripe around the oak dowel in the center. So there are several ways I could do this. One is I could quite simply come up here and draw a 3/4 inch circle around each of these vectors. But in order to demonstrate the offset tool, I've decided to show you how I can offset them all at once with the offset tool. So I have my 3/8 inch circles selected. I'll come over here under offset and layout to the first icon and click that. Now, starting at the top of the form, I have 3 choices I can make. I can either offset the vector outwards, I could offset the vector inwards, or I can do both at the same time. For this situation, I want to offset these vectors outwards. So we'll click on outwards. Now I need a distance. How far do I want to offset these? Well, right now these are 3/8 inch dowel holes. I want the total diameter of the new vectors to be 3/4 inch. So what I'll need to do is figure out how far to offset them to end up with a 3/4 inch circle. 3/8 is half of 3/4. But I don't want to offset 3/8 inch because that would put a 3/8 inch space between this circle and the new circle. That would make the big circle over an inch in diameter. Instead, what I want to do is I want to use half of that measurement. So it's 3/8. I'll cut that in half. That's 3/16. So I'll come up here, and for my distance, I'll type in 3/16. Then I'll tap the equals button on my keyboard, and that gives me the decimal equivalent of 3/16 inch. I now have 3 other choices. I can create sharp offset corners. Well, there are no corners on a circle, so I don't need that. I can delete the original. I don't want to do that. I want to keep this hole as well. Or I can select new. That's what I do want to do. I want to select the new vector after I've offset this one. So I'll click on offset. And if I zoom out, you can see I now have a new vector around all four of these vectors. Now I can close this. What I would normally do is right here, I would go ahead and group these four vectors. Now, I'm not going to do that right now because I want to show you what we've done. So I'll zoom in on this vector here. We know this one is a 3/8 inch diameter circle. We've offset it out by 3/16 of an inch to create this circle here. Now I'll come up here under Transform Objects, click on that icon, and we can see that my width in X and height in Y is 3/4 of an inch. Okay, now I can select all four of these circles, and we can group them. Now, if you recall, I've already calculated tool paths for this file. Now I can go over and I can check my calculations again. I draw that tool path, and that's going to carve these dowels right here, and that's great. I can draw this tool path, and that's going to drill my through holes here. That's great as well. Then I have my profile cutout. That is not going to change. The only thing that is going to change is I'm going to create a pocket tool path for these. And I'm going to want to move it up to the top of the toolpath list. So I'm going to select this group, and I'm going to create a pocket toolpath. And I'm going to use the same cut depth. That'll be 0.375. I'm going to use the same tool. I'm going to use the same strategy. I'm going to change this to 3/4 inch. Walnut dowel, and we'll calculate. And there is this tool path. Now what I want to do is I want to move this up to the top of my tool path list. Now, because this dowel is cutting to the same depth as this dowel, I can't preview both of them at the same time. So what I'll do is I will go ahead and uncheck this, and I'll check these three to make sure that they're still good. And I'll preview the visible toolpaths. And they're still just fine. Now I'll reset my preview, and I'll check this one and these two, and preview the visible toolpaths. And we see they work fine as well. So this is the first toolpath I would run. I would cut that 3/4 inch dowel hole, fill it with the walnut dowel. Then after that was dry and sanded flat, I would come back and I would run these three toolpaths. So we can preview those visible toolpaths, and we can see how it would eventually turn out. Well, now that I've made a modification to this design, and I think a pretty decent looking modification, I want to save this, but I don't want to overwrite my original clock face. So what I'm going to use is a feature called Increment and Save. And what that'll allow me to do is save this copy without having to save as, navigate to the folder, and without overwriting my original file. And I can find Increment and Save up here in the File menu, come all the way down here, and we have Increment and Save. Now, what's going to happen when I do that? Let me look at my folder. Right now, we have the basic clock face. It's going to take this same title, it'll add an underscore, then a number, depending upon how many times you have used Increment and Save. So I'll go File, Increment and Save, and we see the title has now changed to Basic Clock Face underscore 1. And now if I go down to that folder, I have my original, and here is the one we just created. If I decide to make more changes to this file, I can do so. I can, for example, not use these walnut dowels. I could decide to carve text. So here's how I would do that. I would first of all select those dowels and just hit the delete key on my keyboard. Then I want to create 12, 3, 6, and 9 and place them there in those in the appropriate spots. But I'm going to use these circles right here as markers on where I want to put that text. So we'll go over here to my text, and I want to create regular text, not text in a box. We'll get further into creating text in future videos. I'm going to go ahead and use this century font, but I want to make my text height a little bit larger. So I'm going to go with 1 inch. I'll go ahead and I'll use this century font, as I said, and I'll just type 12. And we can see my text was created down here. Now, if I zoom in on my text, personally, I think the 1 and 2 are just a little too far apart. If we look at my cursor has an arrow with a T next to it. That tells me that I'm working with text. If I place my cursor down here between the 1 and the 2, we can see that it has changed again. We have the letter V and the letter A. We also have a couple of arrows in between that are facing inwards. If I click now, each one of these characters is going to move in the direction of the arrows. So if I click, they move slightly closer together. If I click again, they move a little bit closer together. If I decide I have moved them too close together, I can press and hold the Shift key and spread them apart when I click. I want to bring them closer together, so that's what I want to keep right there. So now I'll close the text form. I'm going to put my text into move and transform mode. Now I'm going to grab this center square and I'm going to drag it up into the center of that circle, and you see that it snapped right to the center of this circle. That's why I left those circles there. So now I'll click off. And I'll do the same thing for 3, 6, and 9. Go into text, 3, close, go into move and transform mode, drag it, snap it to the center of that circle. Click off. Text, close, move and transform mode, snap it to the center of that circle. Click off. Text, 9, close, move and transform mode, snap it to the center of that circle. That's all there is to it. Now I can zoom back in here, select that group of circles, and tap delete on my keyboard, and I now have another design using the same basic design. I will need to go in and calculate toolpaths for this design, but for right now, I'll increment and save. We now have basic clock face 2. And when I look in my folder, there is basic clock phase two. So increment and save is a excellent way to modify a file without overwriting that file. You can create a basic design, save that basic design, then later add embellishments and not change that basic design, and saving the file each step of the way. So, I hope you got something out of this video. And if you did, I do hope you'll give me a thumbs up. Now, I know there's no way I answered every question you may have about offsets, when to use an offset, or increment and save, or when to use increment and save. So this afternoon at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, I'll be hosting a live Q&A session where you can ask me any question you'd like about anything I presented in this video or any of my other videos. That's today at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, right here on my YouTube channel. And I've put a link to that live Q&A session down in the description box of this video. Now, before we wrap this up, I'd like to give a special shout out and say a special thank you to all of my channel members. Thank you, channel members. I appreciate your continued support. If you would like information on how to become a channel member, just click that little join button down there next to the subscribe button. Another panel will pop up and a video will play that'll tell you all about channel memberships. So, I hope to see everybody this afternoon for a live Q&A session. And as always, whether you subscribe to my channel or not, whether you become a channel member or not, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the time to watch, and y'all take care.